championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Jared Dudley, no longer a Laker. That's right, the glue guy for LA, the guy in the locker room that kept the team chemistry where you wanted it to be, is unfortunately departing. He will be joining the Dallas Mavericks, but not as a player. Nope, as an assistant coach. We had heard that Jason Kidd might try to poach some of the Lakers coaches now that he is the head coach for the Dallas Mavericks. He actually poached a former Lakers player now in Jared Dudley to get a front of the bench role with him as an assistant coach. Joining me to discuss is Matt the Optimist Peralta. Matt, were you surprised by this, that Jared Dudley is, number one, transitioning into coaching, and then number two, that he's doing it with the Mavs and not the Lakers?
I don't think I'm surprised, honestly. It's unfortunate that's not with the Lakers, but I think head coaching or even, you know, front office stuff was always in the works for Jared Dudley. He's just too smart of a basketball guy and understood his role too well to not imagine him, you know, in that regard. So it's not surprising to me, one, that he's an assistant coach, and two, it's not surprising that it's with the Mavs, given that he and Jason Kidd had spent time together with the Lakers previously. And so bringing in a veteran or a fellow veteran makes sense for the Mavericks to do that. And I think, you know, the role is a lot better than what he would have got in L.A. The front of the bench spots are pretty much taken up now with the Lakers. And so for him to go to Dallas and get that experience, I think is a great opportunity for him. So, no, it's not surprising, but it's definitely a bummer. I like a lot of Lakers fans, and I think, you know, this is universal, but I loved having Dudley on the team. Yes, he never really played, but I think he was that glue guy, that veteran voice in the locker room, the guy that can get to Anthony Davis and LeBron James, but also get to the role players. He was just kind of the guy that really helped the chemistry aspect of things. So I think that's going to be missed. And, you know, just someone that wasn't afraid to speak his mind and give an opinion on things. Like, he was never afraid to do that. And I really respected that about Dudley. So I think this is a loss for the Lakers, but, you know, as all things considered, like, I'm happy for him, and I think he's going to do great.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, look, Dudley, obviously he was preparing for this. He knew, and he had talked about this for a while, that he was either going to move into something in the front office, he was going to move into something in coaching. Someday, maybe he'd look to be a GM. He knew that there was life beyond playing on a basketball team, but life within basketball. Maybe he was going to go into something in front of the camera, do something like that. He had a lot of different options, and now he's going to be an assistant coach with the Mavericks. And like you said, he's the kind of guy that can make connections with a lot of different players, and that's what kept him in the league so long. Number one, he was very, very smart in knowing his role. We talk all about how some guys, they just don't believe that they're a role player. They think that they're better than they are. Jared Dudley was very, very real with himself in terms of understanding what he needed to do to stay in the NBA and what his role was going to be on different teams. And so he just accepted that, look, I'm going to be an end of the bench guy, but I'm going to also make sure that I'm that guy that is keeping the team together, that I'm providing value off the court. And that's exactly what he did for the Lakers. We talk about the chemistry that he came in with the year the Lakers won the championship in 2020, which, again, calendar year wise, that was less than a year ago that happened, that they won that championship. But Dudley was the guy who came in day one, media day, and he's saying, be a star in your role. And that was the mantra that really stuck throughout the season. And we're still seeing the Lakers use that right now. And that's something that Jared Dudley certainly embodied. The Lakers will miss him. They will miss that. But I do think this is a nice move for him. I know we had fans over the years who were saying, why doesn't Dudley just become an assistant coach for the Lakers? Why doesn't he just make that transition now? What's the point? If you're not going to put him in the game, why are you using a roster spot? There is a little bit of a difference between having a guy act as a coach out on the floor and in practices that's actually on the team and playing versus a guy who's just a coach. But I still think Jared Dudley is going to be very, very beneficial to the Dallas Mavericks. And he's a guy that hopefully can really help that team come together, because we have seen a little bit of, you know, give some chemistry issues that have taken place in Dallas. So I think he can be a major help there.
Yeah, you know, as far as the Mavericks side goes, I think it's a great move. You know, Jason Kidd's coming there as a new head coach. You know, he's going to have to learn the team and figure out, you know, how to move the pieces around to make them the best possible team they can be. I think Jared Dudley, as far as a locker room guy, you know, a former player like Jason Kidd himself, I think that's just going to add more credibility to that locker room and on the sidelines there. I think he's going to be a really big help to Luka Doncic and Kristaps Porzingis. We've seen Jared Dudley mentor basically almost every player in the league at this point, upcoming stars, current stars, etc. So I think he's going to be a great resource for Doncic especially. So from a, it's really hard to argue against this move for the Mavericks. I thought they did the smart thing here. And obviously, I think people are going to wonder why the Lakers couldn't offer him a bigger opportunity. It's just kind of the way things go in terms of, you know, business decision there. And I think, you know, as far as the Lakers side concerned, saving that roster spot and not bringing Dudley back, you know, gives them some flexibility when they're talking about building out this roster. We've already heard reports that they're looking to only bring in 14 guys for the regular season and then kind of play the buyout market and see who comes free. So not having Dudley there at least goes a long way in terms of roster building for the Lakers side of things. But as a fan, this is ultimately going to be a bummer. I loved having Dudley on the team, even though he never played. I always looked forward to hearing him speak and talk, and I think that's going to be missed. But again, I think as Lakers Nation, we have to wish him the best. He's a champion forever with the Los Angeles Lakers. Yes, he didn't play much of a role in that playoff run, but he was pretty instrumental in making sure that we got there.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and just think, we look at that bubble playoff run, how important cohesion was, how important that chemistry was, the camaraderie of the team. Jared Dudley is a big part of that, right? Like, the Lakers in the bubble are going to be different without Jared Dudley there behind the scenes doing everything that he needed to do in order to keep that team together. So I think that it would look very different without him. And last piece to this, just in terms of the cap and how all that works out, we had been talking a little bit yesterday about a potential trade for Jeremy Lamb and how there was maybe a path, again, a very unlikely one, but maybe a path if he took some of these guys that the Lakers had rights for, like Jared Dudley, Wesley Matthews, signed them to deals, put them in a sign and trade that would send them out to the Pacers. Obviously, that can't happen anymore because Dudley is now no longer an NBA player and is instead moving into a coaching role. Not earth-shattering news or anything like that. That Jeremy Lamb thing was always extremely unlikely, and again, I still don't see that happening, but again, just to kind of make sure we cover everything there, that's now no longer a possibility in regards to Dudley. All right, guys, but let us know what you think about Jared Dudley moving on to the Dallas Mavericks. Fire off your thoughts in the comments down below. Were you hoping that he would stay on with the Lakers as a coach? Let us know your thoughts. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring the notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see you.